Lead NFL analyst Dalton Miller recently released his top 25 cornerback rankings heading into the 2021 NFL season. When you think about putting together a rankings, there's always going to be room for dialogue here, which I think that's exactly what we're going to get into. If you want to check out the full top 25 cornerbacks on Dalton's list, obviously you can check it out, profootballnetwork.com. The link is in the description below. But Dalton, I really wanted to focus here on your top five cornerbacks that you had listed, because this is where the nuts and bolts come. This is where all the dialogue and the debate really get thrown into the action here. So let's start off with number five, Marlon Humphrey of the Baltimore Ravens. You had him listed there. Now, just some background too on Marlon Humphrey last year. And he's a versatile guy. 8 forced fumbles on the season, 21 times he was sent on blitzes. He had 2.5 sacks on the year. Why Marlon Humphrey here, maybe ahead of somebody, behind him when you look at 6, Stephon Gilmore, or 7, James Bradbury of the New York Giants?
Yeah, when I went through and I did the listings, I really wanted to include consistency over time as a part of this as well. The reason why I didn't have Stephon Gilmore ahead of Marlon Humphrey is because I feel like the 2020 season for Gilmore was a legitimate step back from the pace that he had been on previously. When it comes to James Bradbury, I think that he was a very good player when he was in Carolina and then turned into a great player when he went to New York last year. I think that he had a great season. He might have had a top 5 year last year, but I went with the consistency over time that Marlon Humphrey has produced. And listen, he got his hand on the ball a lot in previous years when it comes to the turnovers from the air. But like you said, last year, 8 forced fumbles, he was still getting his hands on the football last year, even though those interception numbers might not have been as high. And he didn't have the same type of situation on the back end with the safeties that he had had in years past either. So he had to make up for that a little bit himself. His consistency as a corner is why I had him so high.
Well, let's talk about your fourth selection here. This is the one that's causing controversy in your mentions and also in the comment section at profootballnetwork.com. But Xavien Howard comes in at number 4 on this list. And yes, I think we can all sit here and say the season that Xavien Howard had last year for the Dolphins was spectacular. 10 interceptions, yeah. 20 passes defense, and a 48.3 quarterback rating when he was targeted, and he was targeted 101 times last year. Now, before we spoil the rest of the list here, I mean, Xavien Howard, there is an argument to be made that he could potentially be number one here. Why isn't he?
I mean, he probably should have won Defensive Player of the Year last year. I mean, I think that was a legitimate argument. It goes back to the consistency over time. I know that he had, I believe, 7 interceptions in 2018 as well. Wasn't quite able to stay on the field as much in 2019. But he's still somebody who, a little bit like Marcus Peters, who I have, much later here on this list, there's a lot of boom or bust with Xavien Howard. Now, it was a little bit less last year, and he was targeted a lot last year, and he had those opportunities to take the ball away because of Byron Jones being on the opposite side. They were targeting Xavien Howard more, but he is a ball hawk. That is something that you definitely have to give to him. The reason why I didn't have him up with the rest of the guys is because of that propensity at times to give up the big play in a way that I don't believe these other top 3 guys do.
Well, and you also mentioned too, consistency is key. So now we transition to your third selection, Tre'Davious White of the Buffalo Bills. 3 interceptions last year, but if we're going on the terms of consistency and impact, yes, he was that for Buffalo. He allowed a 79.9 quarterback rating when targeted, and he was targeted around the ballpark of about 65 times last season. Some tough matchups as well, but he really was that defensive guy that stood out to me the most in Buffalo, outside obviously their inside linebacking core. Now, for you, why Tre'Davious White at this position in comparison to maybe some of the guys we're going to get to here at number 2 and number 1?
Yeah, so I have Tre'Davious White, I think, a little bit higher than a lot of people do. I love the fire that he shows in the game of football. You see him do a lot on the sidelines. He's up, he's going. He really seems to enjoy the game as he is playing with. He does it on the field, off the field. When I watch my corners, I really like to see that kind of, not as much swagger, but I mean, corners are a lot of the times they're kind of trolly. And that is something that Tre'Davious White does very well. The reason why he is my number 3 and the reason why I have him above of Xavien Howard is that consistency over time. I think that, he has to play a bunch of really tough wide receivers at times. He travels around, and to only be targeted 65 times to me shows that teams do not want to attack him and only will attack him in those situations where they feel they really can take advantage of it. I think that Tre'Davious White is going to continue to get better as he goes, because he's still a very young player in the grand scheme of things.
Tre'Davious White, I mean, he's a thumper too. He's not afraid to come up and tackle, which is necessary too. I think when we factor in some of these rankings, these cornerbacks that you mentioned, they do like to come up and tackle. So now we get to number two, Green Bay Packers, Jaire Alexander, one interception last season, 13 passes defense. He was targeted 80 times and allowed a 67.4 quarterback rating when targeted. He's one of those players too, especially when you factor in that NFC North division. Yes, there's some inconsistent quarterback play from some of those teams, but the Green Bay Packers played some teams that really aired it out last year. And Jaire was a prime example of the key guy that was going to follow around the best wide receiver, and specifically against Mike Evans, I would say even in the NFC Championship game, he was one guy that stood out to me.
I think he's the best pure cover corner in the NFL, even over top of my number one corner. The number one corner on the list just does so many other things out of this world that I couldn't put Jaire at number one. He's been cornerback one in my heart ever since he trolled the Wake Forest wide receiver back in 2016 after he broke up a pass. He kind of put his hands on his hips and like galloped after him. I love that in a player. And I think that when it comes to his ability to mirror and match guys, the fluidity that he plays with and the explosiveness. And for me, it's being a little bit of that, you know, quote unquote, undersized guy. I don't think that he's 6 foot. I'm not sure if he's 190 pounds, but he moves well. He will bang around a little bit as well. He's not as physical as some of these other guys are given his size. But what he does on top of that or in lieu of that is his ability to move and really stay in the hip pocket of any wide receiver that he goes up against. Plus, like you said, against guys like Mike Evans, who are much bigger and much more physical, he competes against those guys just as well.
He's a pest. I mean, that's the thing you mentioned, the trollish behavior. We like that about DBs. He can get into wide receivers' heads really easily. But I don't think there's anybody better that's good at getting into the heads of their opponent than number one, Jalen Ramsey of the Los Angeles Rams. Now, last season, one interception on the year, a 68.1 quarterback rating when targeted. He played on the league's best defense, and he was targeted 71 times, but he has the lowest missed tackle percentage out of all the cornerbacks listed. Why is Jalen Ramsey your consensus number one overall pick?
Yeah, I mean, there's a reason why some teams had him as a safety coming out of Florida State, and it's not because he's not great in coverage, because he's one of, if not the best cover corners in the NFL as well. It's because the dude slaps. I mean, that dude will come downhill, he'll punch you in the mouth, and then he will talk his talk afterwards. I know people, you know, in the DFW area here that have, you know, coined the nickname Sass God, I think, from that interview that he did in the locker room the one time. He is very, like, there's a soul to him that is just different than you get with a lot of other guys. But I mean, he's got the thick frame of a guy like Darrelle Revis had. He is, in my opinion, the closest thing that we've had to Revis Island since Revis Island.
Yeah, he's got that swagger too. And there's one play too against the New York Giants. He shed a block. I mean, he attacked the block and then he just absolutely blasted the wide receiver Golden Tate. And that to me was something I think we look at back on and say, hey, this guy is a dog. And yes, he represents that. Obviously, his contract, he got paid a lot of money. So obviously the top money player comes in at number one. He's lived up to that so far, and the expectations are going to continue in 2021. If you'd like to check out the rest of Dalton Miller's top 25 cornerbacks heading into the 2021 NFL season, check it out, profootballnetwork.com, also in the link in the description below. And also follow him on social media, and make sure you hit the subscribe button on our YouTube channel.